pretty much going to follow what you just said. It's a three-phase process.
Okay.
So in the first phase, it's pretty general. It's not like you have to follow each step. The first phase is analyzing what kind of lie you have,
okay,
what the slope of the lie is like, and what that's going to require to hit off of.
Right.
And then, like you said, wind. First phase is going to be things that affect
The situation. Analyze the situation.
So you, right here, you have a perfect lie, perfect stance, perfect everything, wind pretty calm.
Sure.
But that first phase is going to go over things that kind of affect that.
Okay? Sure.
So phase two would be your routine, which you have. You have your two practice swings, you visualize, and you step in, and you hit. Pretty simple.
Right.
I like it. As long as you do the same thing, I like that routine. And then the third phase is analyzing the shot. Do you analyze shots, or do you just hit it, and then you go up there and you just...
You mean, like, after the shot, say, like, what went wrong?
A little bit, yeah. I mean, I kind of looked at, since we talked, I think it was, like, a week or two ago about, cause and effect in terms of ball flight laws.
Right.
I've really thought a lot about, where did the ball start, and then after that, where the ball curved in relation to that. So, in kind of following that process, yes, I do. That's kind of as far as I go.
Okay. So you do. So that's my simple three-phase process.
Yeah.
Pretty simple. Do you like it?
Yeah.
I mean, obviously, it's time-oriented, so you're obviously going to check the lie, the slope, the wind, things that are going to affect your shot.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to realize what kind of shot you need to hit, required.
Right.
And then phase two is kind of getting into that shot, so your routine, actually executing the shot. And then phase three is obviously analyzing, so you can make tweaks for next time.
Sure.
Do you like that?
I like it a lot.
Step in here for a second. I know you're feeling a little bit like this. So one thing that you can work on is feeling like almost like there's a wall above my head. And you don't want to break that wall. You want to swing under it a little bit.
Okay.
So you're kind of turning around a little
bit. Like a low ceiling or something like that?
Right. So instead of hitting that wall,
right.
I really want you to swing around your body and feel like that club face is really under that wall. Okay. So another thing that could help with that is kind of keeping your weight, exchanging that weight a little bit to your back right here.
Yeah.
So, because if you stay up here, it's harder to get that club around
right.
you if you're staying
you
up here.
Here.
Right.
Okay.
If you're up here, you're going to want to swing up this way a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
So if you could bring that back, it's definitely going to let you, turn your hips and get under that wall that we were talking about.
Okay.
So you want to hit a couple like that?
Sure.
So if that helps you?
Yep.
Okay, so I'm going to show you that five-stop process. Process that I was going to talk about. Okay. First step in the process. I look at kind of like my lie, right? So the kind of lie I'm looking at. So is it buried? Right. You need to give a little bit extra so I can get out,
mm-hmm.
or is it teed up for me so I have a really good lie and I don't have to give as much effort to kind of get it going? So that's the first thing I look at. The second thing I look at is kind of what kind of chip am I hitting, and how the green is going to react to that kind of chip.
Okay. First is the lie, and second is the type of shot.
Right.
Much?
Kind of. Yeah. So, reading the green, I know that this kind of shot right here is severe right to left, right? And it's also not that long. But I know the ball is still going to roll out a little bit. Okay. So, I'm going to look at the green. So, obviously, I'm not going to aim at the hole or left of the hole. It's going to break even more left. I'm trying to see where that ball is going to end up after I hit it, or after it lands on the green. So, that brings me to my next step, is where I want to land this chip shot. Stop. No, it's definitely going to run out a little bit, but I kind of want to get it through this fairway and this rough kind of onto the green, so I'm going to pick a spot maybe just onto the fringe maybe. So I would say maybe like right around here.
Yeah.
Right, so that's kind of far enough. I don't think it's going to roll out too far, and it also is going to break a little left, so I think that's a pretty good spot right there. Kind of the fourth thing that I go through now is my own pre-shot routine. So whether you take practice strokes or not, which I recommend for a short game, I kind of just get into a habit of brushing the grass maybe 3 to 4 times, and then I'm really visualizing that shot in my head before I actually hit it. And then obviously the fifth step is hitting the shot, and then after hitting the shot, evaluating what happened, what you could have done better. Using your bounce, you're going to want to bring that butt of the club closer to your belt buckle.
Okay.
And then
a little more straight up.
Right. And relative to that, I like to open my face to kind of let that bounce do its work.
Sure.
And let, it's there to help you. Okay.
Okay.
And then the third thing with that is opening your stance just a little bit. Because if you open your face, it's going to go a little right. So you're just going to want to aim a little bit left. get open. Get into right. So get into a little comfortable position. Like I said, three things. Butt of the club at your belt buckle.
Okay.
Expose the bounce by opening the face just a hair, and then opening your face just a little bit.